Then I went back for sex. I swear that I swear I do. Yeah, I woke up in Paris.
I woke up
in with a bad,
bad.
Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Green on hand as we call the action today. Welcome to the Target Center in Minneapolis, Minnesota. It's game one of the NBA Finals between the Minnesota Timberwolves and the Milwaukee Bucks. Milwaukee's been superb so far throughout these playoffs. They've reached their goal of making the NBA Finals. Now here in game one, Jeff, what's the key for them to take the next step?
Well, the finals are so different. The amount of media attention. You've got to stay with that laser-like focus that got you here. But people are hounding you. Media requests, ticket requests. Who can stay locked in?
Sloppy ball handling. There's a steal. Let's it go. And he nails it. A long two.
Transition basketball, critical to scoring enough points to win. It usually comes through.
And it's stolen. Ball comes loose. Fires again. Gets the two. Lucky roll.
You need numbers in transition to score consistently here. Forcing the turnover, then pushing the ball ahead and getting the two-point shot.
And Jeff Teague with the jump shot. Knocks it down for three. He's averaging 13 points per game this season.
Corner three, it's a short shot, and he knocks it home.
Knocks down a three-pointer.
All kinds of confidence on that three-pointer. Great-looking shot.
And he curls in, adjusting on the shot. Teague's unable to drop it in off the glass.
No paint game, no winning. You've got to get the ball at the basket, and then you've got to finish when you get it there.
He wants three more, knocks it down, another three.
Nice follow through on that shot, gets the three to drop.
Boy, they need to get something going here. Ball loose again, here's a steal. Oh, there's that Euro step move, pretty. Nice job drawing the foul. It's called against Gibson. All right, getting ready now for the first of two free throw attempts.
Oh, that was great body control to be able to absorb the contact and still get off a quality shot. Just didn't get it to drop.
And he makes them both. Oh, excellent screen. Teague on the drive at the rim, has to adjust. And gets it to go off the glass.
Keep doing what you do. There's dribble penetration. You give support, make him take, and make a tough shot.
Whistle sounds, out of bounds. Teague wide open. Shot in and out. Pulls up from downtown. George is using the screen, trying to get free. Puts it up from downtown. Nails it. It's a double-digit lead.
That's a thing of beauty right there. The three-point shot, nothing but net.
Ball knocked out of his hands. And there's a steal. And another one from deep with another three.
Sweet stroke on that shot, Mike. It looked good as soon as it left his hand.
To Wiggins. He loses control of it. Oh, he loses it. Ooh, he gets hit in the head. Didn't see that one coming. Beats his man. Oh, it's turned back by George. looking for another three here. The Bucks with the offensive rebound for another possession. Wiggins looking for the screen to get himself open. Great pass. Knocks it down. That's his first shot of the night. The comeback kid has embraced a lot of the creativity that comes with competing in pro-ams. This style of play between street courts and NBA arenas has blended together into a special kind of player.
I look back often before his rookie year, the time he spent in the Drew League and being mentored by James Harden, that Harden would take the time to give his wisdom and his vast experiences to this young man was really a good thing to see. And for the comeback kid to take that knowledge and use it so productively, good stuff.
And we'll have a timeout. The Bucks up by 15.
Hey, it's up again. Let's take it
the
home
Timberwolves
now.
Get the inbound in here. On the drive. Oh, he tried to put it in off the glass.
Hey, it's been one of those nights where nothing's been easy for them in the paint. Terrific team defense forcing that miss.
To Beasley. Takes another shot. It's good. That'll be a two-pointer. Jeff Teague with 11 points.
And sometimes being too open makes it harder to make. Right there wasn't the case. No hesitation. Easy two-point jump shot.
Quick move to get inside. Gets a piece of it. Looks to the post. Wiggins fires from downtown all alone. 1 minute remaining in the first quarter. Milwaukee's up by 18. Kicks it back out, looking for consecutive three-pointers. Bang, another three.
Made the most of his opportunity, and he knocked it in. Three ball.
To T, wide open for three. Oh, in and out.
A wide open miss. But those are the type of shots they're going to have to keep creating and start making to work their way back into this game.
And the rebound grabbed by Anthony Towns. He's among the league leaders in rebounding this season. Wiggins, it's bank shot just off the mark.
It's happened over and over again tonight. Missing shots at the basket area.
For three, Jabari Parker with his fourth assist of the night.
What a beautiful stroke right down the heart of the basket. Big time three.
Ball knocked loose. Oh, he gets the steal. Oh, nice block. He's up on the shot and passes it out and goes out of bounds. Can't hold on to the ball. And he just flips it up as time winds down. And the shot counts. And the first quarter complete. The Bucks up by. Not the way they wanted to start this game. Comeback kid every year, something different, something better. His desire for greatness is just unbelievable, Jeff. That work ethic is second to none.
Yeah, the sustainment of the work ethic is what's truly impressive. A lot of players can work at a good rate for a finite period of time, but the comeback kid, he's different. He's been able to do that day after day, year after year, summer after summer.
Knocks it down from way downtown. And here's another look at that three-pointer. And Minnesota calls yet another timeout. That didn't take long. And Andrew Wiggins will get the inbound in here. Rose. Fires away for two, and he will go to the line for some free throws. Whistle blows, it's a foul.
Team foul number four, Milwaukee Bucks.
Off the mark on the first free throw. So he goes 1-for-2 from the line after hitting the second. Minnesota's got to be aware of how badly they need a stop. Just a matter of can they do it. Fires for three from the corner. Doesn't get the roll. As they bring it up, desperate for a score. Help defense there with the switch. Good solid entry pass. Fires away for two. Nice finish around the rim. Puts it up from three-point land. Won't go from outside the arc. Telegraph that pass for the turnover. He puts it up. That's a two. And it's a 32-point lead for the Bucks.
They haven't wasted any time in establishing an offense based around ball movement and player movement, and the results speak for themselves.
They double him. George is trying to get free off the pick. Rose the rebound. There's the pick to Zhang. Adjusting in the air. And it's on to the free throw line. One shot to complete the three-point play. And here's another look at that solid finish at the rim. Able to hit the free throw, and it's a three-point play. Oh, he threw it out of bounds. Capella's been tough. And Boogie Zhang will be the man for the inbound. To T.
Hey, watch this screen left.
Entry pass gets it inside. To Rose. Wide open for three. And puts it in. Minnesota shooting 78% from downtown this season. An 8-0 run for the Timberwolves. From three-point land, it's good. He's feeling it now.
Excellent balance. Beautiful release. Knocked it in.
Teague's using the screen. Good play. Gets the steal. Strong at the rim.
Never assume. Keep playing the game. Force the turnover, which happened, and then take advantage of that opportunity. Push the ball up the court and keep putting the hammer to him. Continue to push forward in this blowout.
Rose. He shoots. Touch there, not this time. Gets past the defense. Nice. For two. Teague the rebound.
This team is in dire straits. They need a
good hands. Gets the steal. Can't hit from downtown. Teague against Bledsoe. Capella for two, lets it go. It'll count if it goes. And time expires here to end the first half. The Bucks up by 29. Stay tuned for halftime. We'll be back shortly.
The Bucks absolutely dominated the competition in the first half.
And the offensive glass was their domain. They score plenty of second chance points, asserting themselves in the paint. These are the guys getting buckets for the Milwaukee Bucks. The Timberwolves did a lot of things wrong in that opening half. There isn't enough time to get into all of their problems. But I'll tell you this, they need to try to get better. These are the guys getting buckets for the Minnesota Timberwolves.
Game track. steals.
The Minnesota Timberwolves seem to be giving the ball away in this matchup like they're working for it. All right, back to the second half. I'll see you after the game.
Puts it up, deep corner shot, and hits the three.
Milwaukee's showing so much confidence with the three-point shot. It's a big reason for their lead.
Loses the control. Nice display of extra hustle. Oh, but they'll change possession. Quick catch and shoot.
Great effort right there. Listen, it didn't work out the way he had wanted with the ball being saved inbounds, but you can't fault his effort.
Tries to go for back-to-back threes here. It's a loose ball. Comes up with a pretty steal. Shoots the three. Strong rebound by Butler. screen set nicely. To Wiggins. That's a three-pointer. The defense nowhere near him. He sinks it. Jeff Teague's 2 for 3 from long range.
This man makes it look easy, shooting the ball from deep.
Careless ball handling. There's a steal. Puts up another three-pointer. Puts it in. He's in rhythm now.
That's a thing of beauty right there. The three-point shot, nothing but net.
Sloppy ball handling. To the rim. It's up and gets the roll.
Second half, it's easy when you're winning big to take possessions off. Here, they didn't do that. Force the turnover, run it down their throat, and then make them pay for their lackadaisical attitude towards the game.
Tries it again. Great rebounding on the offensive glass. Terrific rejection. The comeback kid proved just how special he was in year one. Hey, Jeff, what do you think's on tap for year two?
To take greater control of his team and his locker room. Setting a great example, but also holding his teammates accountable for their performances, their attitudes, and their habits. When you play as well as the comeback kid has, you now have the mantle of leadership, and he's got to come through.
In and out. And back outside. Down into the lane. Goes to the goal. And Paul George with a nice shot for two.
This defense is the reason why they cannot compete here tonight.
Wiggins finds a space and takes the wide open three. Minnesota's definitely needing a big time defensive play. Antetokounmpo with a rim rocking slam. Wow. They need a timeout here. The Timberwolves down by 38.
This was a necessary timeout to regain control of this game. The momentum is going against you. You as a coach have to take control and get your team organized once again.
To Wiggins.
Oh, no, he can't guard you out there.
Pulls up. Soft touch, gets the roll. He's got 7 points thus far. Goes for the three-pointer. Rebounded by Butler. Into the front court, desperate for some points. Ball comes loose, and it's stolen. Double team closing in to the rim, and he'll head to the line again and shoot two. And we have a foul called against Beasley. That'll be his second personal.
That one deserves another look. Here comes the replay.
Shooting two. First free throw, good. And that's his 8th rebound of the game. To Rose. Gets to the rim. Oh, that's a pretty finish on a beautiful pass from Derrick Rose.
Nice work getting into the paint to finish.
Pulls up for three. Bang! Hits from downtown.
What a beautiful stroke. Right down the heart of the basket. Big time three.
Here's the switch. Ball loose again. Here's a steal. Going for back-to-back threes. Jang the rebound. From beyond the arc. Bang. And there's a timeout here in the late stages of the third period.
Made the most of his opportunity and he knocked it in. Three ball.
The Timberwolves get to inbound. To Rose.
Number 24,
Ball knocked out of his hands, and there's a steal. Gets inside, puts it up, and it's back to the free throw line for two more free throws.
Yep, he hit him. A foul called against Rose. Yeah, that one's worth seeing again. Here's the replay. And he connects on the first free throw. And gets both points from the line. Beats him off the dribble. Quick decision and gets rid of it. Derrick Rose with his sixth assist of the night.
You can tell both of these teams are completely unselfish with the basketball. Look at the assist total, and you can tell that both teams have learned very well that sharing is the true joy in this game.
He loses control of it. The ball stolen. To the basket, banks it in for two.
When you're playing with a big lead, your players cannot take possessions off, and I like the example that this unit is showing. Forcing a turnover and then not resting, not conserving energy, pushing the ball and getting a transition opportunity.
He loses it, and the ball is stolen. Minnesota's now back on defense. They need a big stop to turn things around. And he'll head to the line for the third time tonight. Draws the foul. It's called against Wiggins. That's his second foul. And he hits the first free throw. Hits the second free throw. One more to come. And he hits all three free throws. To Gibson. Oh, excellent screen. To Wiggins. Trying to work it down low. Rose on the drive. And he throws it down.
Now that's just raw athleticism right there. Blow by, goes up, finishes with a hard dunk.
Drives inside, knocks it down. A two-pointer. Milwaukee's up by 32. That's a 10-2 run for the Bucks. To Rose. In the paint, flips it up, and it rolls in.
You need guys who can beat their man off the dribble and finish at the basket.
From downtown, that's a three.
Sweet stroke on that shot, Mike. It looked good as soon as it left his hand.
Ball knocked loose. Ball goes out of bounds. It'll be Timberwolves' ball. Wiggins looking to get free off the screen. Can't hold on to the ball. To the basket, flips it up, and lays it home.
Hey, you get blown out for reasons in this league. Here, getting to the rim in transition, this is just another sign that the defensive intensity was not up to par when it needed to be in this game.
Now time for a couple of free throws. He says no, but the ref says foul. Call against Antetokounmpo. Let's have another look at that play.
Man, I thought that was going to be an and one. Good strength just whipped out.
Knocks down the first one. And Derrick Rose with 16 points. Shoots for three. Oh, quick move, gets inside. Puts up another shot. Just won't go for point-blank range. And this game's all wrapped up. The final score is 190.
The Bucks got themselves a win here today. They did it with blocks, and they did it with steals. More to the point, they did it with excellent defense. They committed to the here the guys
player of the
who
game
put up the most points for the Milwaukee Bucks. When you see these highlights,